Welcome back, folks. Today we're going to take a look at another new generator. This one's the Dinking 2300 watt inverter generator. It's the DK2300i-M. It's made by Dinking Power Machinery, and if you haven't heard of them, that's okay, but Dinking has been around for a while now, making inverter generators for many other brands that you probably have heard of, like Genmax, Duramax, and I think, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure they make quite a few of the Predator line of generators for the Nationwide Tool Store, if you know who I'm talking about. But anyway, they finally started selling generators under their own company name. But we're going to get into this and we're going to see what comes with it. Just to show you here, this is how it comes. It says you can see the specs here, 2300 watt, 1800 continuous, 120 volt, 60 hertz electricity, 79.7 cc engine, 0.6 of a gallon of engine oil. I did the math on that. It seems to work out to be about just over one third of a quart. We'll find out when we go to actually put the oil in there. But as you can see, it says silent, compact, easy to start, recoil system, low oil, shutdown, fuel efficient. You get the idea. But let's take a look and see what's inside here. Okay, so I got the box opened up. And as you can see, it comes with a funnel that screws into the fill port. And it comes with a spark plug tool and a screwdriver. And then, of course, this lifts out. And you've got the top of the generator itself. Let me get this out of the box here. And you can see it's shipped. It's got foam padding all around all four sides. So that's pretty darn nice. And let me get this unboxed, and we'll take a closer look at it. Okay, so we got it out on the table here. As you can see on the front panel here, we got some USB ports for charging at a USB-A and a USB-C. It's the first time I've seen a USB-C on a generator, I think. You got your standard 120 volt plugs, 20 amp. You got your parallel ports, CO detector light, a grounding lug, reset for the outlets, low idle switch, and you got your indicator lights there. And on the side here, you can see where we were talking earlier about the oil. Capacity for the oil is 0.35 of a quart. So like I said, just over a third of a quart, or 11.2 ounces. And 2300 starting watts, 1800 running watts. Comes with the manual attached. Got the exhaust port. And you got your switch over here for run, start, and stop. And of course your pull start there. It's there's no electric start on this one. This is meant for, you know, as compact as possible. And like I said, dimensionally, compared to the Harbor Freight Predator 2000 watt generator, which is has the same 1800 running watt capacity, this thing is dimensionally smaller. And we're gonna set these two side by side when we get outside and compare them. But this thing is lighter and smaller than the Predator. And of course you got your gas cap up here, if you can probably see that. It's got a vent on it. It's got an access cover here on the top for your spark plug. It even has the part number for the different brands of spark plugs, so you don't have to wonder what spark plug it takes. And pretty nice little compact unit. I'm excited to try it out. If this thing really does do the 1800 watts like advertised, this is going to be a pretty nice little unit because it's very, very compact. We'll take the side cover off here so we can look at the oil fill. Okay, so that cover just snaps right off there after you get the four screws out. And we'll set that to the side. This is your fill port and how you check the oil. But on these, you really don't need a dipstick because, like it shows on the picture, this is kind of a drawing of how the engine block is designed. And with this unscrewed, which is this here, with that unscrewed, you can only pour oil in so far before it starts pouring back out. And when it starts to pour back out, that's when you know it's full. So you really don't need a dipstick. This is the funnel that comes with it. It screws in there. It actually threads in. And there's an O-ring on the end of it. So it seals tight to the opening. And you can pour your oil in. And then as far as changing your oil, instead of having a drain plug, you just screw this in. And then just tip the generator on its side and oil will run back out into your drain pan or whatever. Let's get this thing outside. We'll get it started up. We're going to do some electrical load testing. We'll do some sound testing, and we'll compare it to the Predator 2000 watt generator. And I think we're even going to be able to parallel this generator to the Predator, and we'll see if we can get 3,600 watts out of the two of them. Just a few pictures here to show a size and weight comparison. The Dinking generator is 37 pounds. The Predator is 52 pounds. The difference in size and weight is quite noticeable, especially when you consider the smaller generator is the one that makes more power. Okay, well, we're outside now, and I've got the generator set up about 21 feet away from my testing station. And you can see here, I've got an adapter plugged into my, basically an overgrown extension cord. That is strictly an adapter. It doesn't change the electricity in any way. It's not converting anything. It's just an adapter to make the cord work. Let's get her started up here and we'll do some testing. Eco-throttle off, eco-throttle on. We'll leave it on for our testing until we do the actual sound testing, then we'll turn it back up. And as you can see here, I've got an extension cord laid out with the tape measure. It goes all the way over to the corner of my temporary garage that I used for parking my truck this past winter. And I'm using it to help shade the sunlight for filming. And I've got this concrete mixing tub over my test rig. Let me move that right now. And I've got that on its own camera. That electrical box there is basically a power distribution box that I put a meter on. And it has overcurrent protection with two breakers, splits it off into two circuits. It's got two GFI outlets. I did a video on it a while back. I'll post a link below if you're interested in that box. But the main reason why it was built was for distributing power with a different generator. But it turned out to be a darn good testing rig here for testing generators. So let me put the sun shield back on it. And I'll pull up that camera so we can see what the generator is currently doing. And then over here, I've got two electric heaters that we're going to use for a load. And then next to that, I've got two 250-watt heat lamps, old school, old style filament light bulbs on a dimmer switch, so I can slowly increase the load from 100 watts to about 500 watts, give or take. Okay, we got everything plugged in here, and you can see it's currently at 124 volts, which is perfect, 59.9 hertz, and you can see the sine wave looks perfect on that electricity. Let's start putting it under load. This generator is rated at 1600 watts. So we're going to use one electric heater. On low is 750, on high is 1500. And then we'll use these heat lamps to dial it in right up to 1600. Okay, I heard the generator. It's 768 watts, still over 120 volts, 122 volts. We'll go up to high. We're still at right basically 120 volts, 119.8. 1430 watts. Let's see if we can turn the lights on here. That brought her to 1530. Let's bring it up a little more here. It's rated to 16. There is 16 right there. There's 1600 watts. Still 119 volts. Perfect sine wave at full load. That's a good test right there. Let's see how much more it can handle. There's 17. 17.2. Sounded to bog down a little bit, so I killed the load a little bit. That was a pretty good test. It does everything that it's supposed to do with clean electricity the whole time. Perfect sine wave. The voltage never dropped below 120. And it did more than the rated 1600 watts. Let's see if we can parallel this thing with the Predator. Before we parallel this thing, let's do a quick sound test before we forget. Now keep in mind, there's fences around this yard and there's structures nearby, so we may get sound bouncing back and forth. But let's just give this a sound test here. 56 or 57 on low idle. I'm standing at 22 feet, basically. It's right around 60. So not too bad. Okay, now let's do a parallel test. Just for fun, both generators are now idling. You can see a green light on each unit. They're both on low idle. Right around 58 or 59. It's honestly not that loud in person. Okay, so the way this should work, when you parallel two generators that are of different sizes, you don't add the two together. You double the smallest of the two ratings. So in this case, the Predator is actually 1600 and the Dinking is 1800. So we should be able to double the 16 rating and get 3200 watts out of the pair. So let's see what we can get. So, with that in mind, 3200 watts, we'll turn this on. It should be like 750-ish. You can see there now on the meter, obviously this is metering the output of both combined generators. We still got a perfect sine wave, and we still got perfect 60 hertz, still over 120 volts. Not bad. All right, let's go to high on this one. That should be 1500, give or take. Then on this one, we'll go, should be like 2250-ish. Now it's 2180, 2190, 2185. Now we're at 2837. Okay, let's go down here. Let's start cranking this up. There's 3,000. There's 3,130, roughly. That's the rated output. And look at there. We're down just a touch on voltage. But my guess would be that's the Predator that's letting us down. I mean, don't get me wrong, that's still within total spec. I think the voltage at my house on from my power company on a good day is 118 or 119. So that's not bad. It just wasn't the full 120 we saw earlier with just the dinking. Amps. All right, let's see what we got here. Crank it up a little more. That's as much load as I have. 2770. I need to add more light bulbs if I want to create more load. But I'd say that's pretty good. Not bad at all. Look at that, perfect sine wave, perfect 60 hertz. Two different brands of generators. However, more than likely made by the same company in the same factory. But let me kill some of this load here. All right. Considering that the dinking, at the time of this filming anyway, is considerably less money than the Predator, it's smaller, it's lighter, it puts out more wattage. I don't know how you beat it. It's a great deal. I mean, it works perfectly. The price makes it unbeatable. If you're in the market for a generator in this category, don't be afraid to check this one out. This one's definitely worth looking at. So, in fact, I'm going out of town in a few weeks, and that's probably going to be the generator I take with me. Anyways, that's all I have for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.